guess where I'll be? Back at the moors. Lovely little rainbow over there. It's a bit misty today, but at least us have a rainbow. Yes, it's good to be back on Dartmoor at last. It has been a long time coming. I felt so good after last walk, fitter, ready for anything, and now I've probably let myself go again. I'm going to be wheezing all the way up there. I haven't smoked, I haven't done any fags smoking, so that's been quite good. There's old Nath back again.
Yeah,
been a long while, hasn't it? What's it been, about 5-6 weeks?
It's been a while. Lots happened since then, hasn't it?
Yeah.
The main, you know, one of the key points we want to sort of touch on is the fact that we didn't go out and get a helmet smashed last night and run, which had happened previously. So we're feeling a lot better and a lot more motivated. Moby's back with us. He's there somewhere.
So we're up at Okehampton Camp, isn't it, you said?
Yeah, we come up past Okehampton Camp. First things first, we'll need to find out on the map where exactly we are, and then start picking tours from there, really.
We're a bit stuck here. We know we're here somewhere. It's Okehampton Camp. But we've driven past it, come off somewhere. We're in this general area.
I think, where's the Ford crossing? Can you come over here? I think we've passed here. I think we're here somewhere.
Did you think? Well, we're right next to the marker. If you look out the window.
Yeah, on the outskirts of the danger zone somewhere, aren't we? Yeah, we could be somewhere here, I reckon. Right, so...
A little bit of a dilemma there.
Yeah, we turned up, drove right into the moors, didn't really think to work out exactly where we were before we got here, and then we turned up and we had a bit of a panic, didn't we?
Yes.
The compasses were both pointing north in two totally different
opposite
directions.
We didn't get that on camera, that would have been good to look at.
But we were just definitely trapped in some sort of vortex of
Bermuda Triangle vortex.
But after a brief 5-minute session of panic and wandering around looking for features, what we found is this fenced off area, which is like some form of farm. I don't know if you can make the chimneys out just over the crest down there. And then we've got this like corner of the property which seems to follow the line of the danger zone, which goes down and is marked all the way down there. So that gives us a real nice prominent feature to sort of take a bearing from, and now we can sort of go about working out where we are. And this is the corner where we're at.
Yep.
Yeah, so we can sort of use that as a known point, orientate the map, and then we can start picking up and placing tours.
What's that one, that tour up there then?
Behind that, that is Belstone.
That's Belstone there, is it?
By the looks of things, because that's, we're stood here, we're looking at that. And then that little outcrop up there, I believe is Oak Tor.
Yeah.
So now we'll briefly pick a route, take a bearing, and get up the first hill, shouldn't us?
Yeah.
Get on it.
Get on it.
So we're just, because it's so misty today, and you know, it's been a long time since I navigated in bleak conditions like that, and you know, picking the tops of tours off for accurate navigation might be difficult. What we're going to do is we're just going to take it steady, make sure we're always aware from which direction we came and which route, and we're going to try and sort of use this path, go up the side of the hill, and once we hit the ridge, we'll just slowly meander our way up onto Belstone. This is the first time since training for the Summit or Nothing challenge that we've started navigating in sort of rougher weather conditions, and you wouldn't believe it, it's July start of the summer holidays in the south of England, and lo and behold, it's raining. So last time we came out, which was in June at some point, when was it, beginning of June?
Beginning of June.
End of June, like, maybe?
Over halfway through July.
Yeah, and I got sunburnt on my head, heat exhaustion, a little bit of sunstroke, and now right in the slap bang in the middle of summer, and you'd think it was autumn. So, yeah, I guess that's the way the weather is up here, I guess.
Since we come out last, quite a lot's happened in the world, or in this country anyway. We've had Brexit, we're no longer part of the European Union. We've got a new Prime Minister on the basis that no one else wanted the job. But more locally to us, there's been a lynx escape on Dartmoor. This is Dartmoor. I doubt we'll see it because they're quite elusive. And I don't think it's been caught yet, has it?
Not that I've heard.
I heard, the last thing I heard, that the rescue team hadn't found the lynx, but they'd found hundreds of Pokemon.
Didn't some woman walk into a motorway or something and have an accident and claimed, or started trying to blame it on the app? So when you're playing Pokemon Go, it's totally acceptable for all common sense to go out the window and blame it on the people that made the game, because that's the
ridiculous
fucking world we live in.
Ooh, we want to cross down here, do we?
Found some water in us.
This is a bit watery.
Found another fucking stone to fight me.
He's on a little scritcher boat.
Where is it, Mobes? I remembered when we come out last time, it was quite hassle-free without the dog running off and fucking digging around, and now he's just...
He's only gone and got a ruddy stone. Well, I don't think you want to cross into that bit, because you've just got to cross again.
Hey?
So you don't want to cross over to that bit, because then you just got to cross again. If we cross here, we only got to cross once, haven't we?
Well. Yeah. How's that working out for you?
Well, if we can cross here, from, oh, I'll come with you. Oh, Nathan loves to be proven right, doesn't he? Here we are. Hello, Mobley. Murdered of us.
Come on, then. Good food.
I'm going to go stone stacking later.
Is that what we're doing?
Shell us. Gonna have a look at that little summit over there while we're here.
Yeah.
That little
I was gonna then go around and then up.
Yeah.
I was thinking.
A little box.
What's that?
It's a
cable.
It is a cable.
Nothing.
You summiting or nothing, Mobes? Which one are you? He's all.
Did you just say that?
Yeah. Did you just say that? Oh, I do love Dartmoor, look at it. Even in the mist, still something to. Really appreciate it, isn't it, Nate? Isn't it, Mobes? Well, the first hill of the day. I just sort of slowly trudged up. Hasn't been too hard on me. A little bit breathless, but well, it's proper misty out and around today. Got ponies down there. Trev and Moby over there. We can't see any other tours from where we are. So navigation is going to be important today. I wonder if mist will break up at all today, or whether that's us in.
Top of that one, do we?
Shall we? Yes, we shall we?
Yeah, I could have a flap somewhere. I'm fucking busting.
What have you found, the links?
It looks like I'm pissing all over the straps of my rucksack, actually. Happy days. Nothing like a bit of wind and outdoor pissing.
Whoa, there goes me hat. He's got it. Well, here we are up at the top of Belstone Tor. It's ever so windy. I don't know if you can hear me over the microphone. We've not really given it any real tests of proper wind yet. So I'm shouting just in case.
Wind!
It's proper windy up here. But it just all come of all of a sudden. It wasn't windy over there when he was up on there.
Wind!
It? Wind!
Fuck knows. It's miserable, isn't it?
Did you call me? What's wrong with my nose? The tremendous views from up here today. I'd like you to have a look. It's good, isn't it? Nah, that was... See, I'm filming down there. Proper misty, proper windy. This is different than all this clear, fair weather walking we've been doing.
This is Dartmoor.
This is Dartmoor, and today, Nath's trusting me to navigate. So this could be a long video. We'll have a look.
It could turn into a survival video.
Yeah. But we didn't bring as much food today. We'd be cooking the dogs. Trying the stone stacking.
Yeah, is that going to go? Sort of might get this chunk of granite sit on that tiny little point like that. Then I suddenly realise it's blowing a fucking gale.
Blowing a Dorothy gale.
Yeah.
We'll get the map out in a minute, we'll find some shelter.
Yeah.
Get the map out and find some bearings, shall us?
Yeah, so let's go back to that bit a bit further down.
Yeah, it's a bit quiet down there, isn't it?
Yeah, where did you hear someone shouting from?
Oh, just over there, when I was having a wee, I just heard. It might have been that woman we passed walking the dog.
Did she shout, "Rock in a cock on him!"
No.
Oops!
What you got? Look at it. Hear that?
I did hear that.
Definitely hearing some shouting. Could have been calling her dog. Links.
Oh no, like someone thinking we're in trouble and come looking for us, like,
yeah.
What do you want to do? Somewhere around here?
Yeah, find people.
Got that smoke?
Moby! It's just saying hello.
Hi.
Morning. Well, it's coming a lot mistier at the minute. it does look like it's thinning. It's got a bit brighter. So we're going to find somewhere to have a brew right now. What's your thoughts, Nath?
Thinking about peanuts, or some sort of nutty type bar.
Get your mug out and have a little brew.
I haven't all brought up, has it?
Jealous.
I've been debating about getting although I've had this mug for years, I've been debating about getting a smaller mug.
Yeah.
Because it works great if you use the water bottle that's designed for it to sit over the top of it. But as I don't, it just seems to consume space in the bag.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about getting a little titanium one, like similar size to yours, but they're like 35 quid.
Just get a little tin one. I don't know, why do you need titanium?
It's all about getting lighter weight.
Yeah, but that hardly weighs anything.
Every gram counts when you're carrying all the camera equipment.
That's all I carry in camera equipment. Yeah, the landscape's coming back. Good job we stopped here.
It's a good job it come back before we got fucking lost. Taking a bearing from Hound Tor to that road and the junctions on it down there. I would suggest that we are at Hound Tor. Yeah.
Right then, buddy. Are you ready to rock and roll?
Yeah.
Well, put your sack on.
You want to see my sack?
Your rancid man sack. Right, so we're going to go Belstone Tor, which we can't see again.
Yeah, we're going to go and look at something that we can't see much of. A minute ago, down there, we could see clear as day, the farm, the tracks. We had a brief respite from this mist to be able to take a bearing, find out exactly where we are and where we want to go. Now, the moment we're about to start moving again, we can't see fuck all. Yeah. But that's Dartmoor, isn't it? Summit or nothing.
I don't know where it's coming from. There's no bloody hole in the clouds.
Just come up Irishman's Wall from Hound Tor. Hound Tor. Or whatever the frick it was, and we think this is Belstone. I hope it is, because we're going to take a bearing from the top of this tour to where we're going next. So if this isn't Belstone, we're probably going to get lost.
Properly lost.
Although we take a bearing, just make sure we also look at what general direction. So if we do end up getting lost on the way to the next one or at the next one, or wherever we go, we know which direction to walk back.
See our next thing to take a bearing from, or the next tour we were going to walk to.
Winging a prayer, innit?
That's how I live life, Nath.
Winging it.
Winging it and praying. We're just going to end up spending all day walking around these three tours. There! There's another lump there, Nath.
So we've got a valley down that side with a river. Maybe this is Irishman's Wall, maybe that's Belstone. I have to get the map out again. Yeah, Irishman's Wall is 479. Belstone goes down to 460, so there's like a 19 metre difference between the height of the two. Although saying that, no, that's That's just another peak on Belstone Common by the looks of things. But this is right, there is a valley and a river next to us. We need to go straight that way, I think, pretty much. I think we need to assume this is Belstone.
You know what they say about assume?
It's the mother of all fuck-ups.
If assumption. You assume, you make an arse out of you and me.
Yeah? Right there, should be. Can't see fuck all. You can just about see the.
What is it we're looking for?
That is Cosdon Beacon, is what it is. By the time we get to the river down the bottom, we're going to climb 200 metres to the top. Yeah.
Shall us?
Oh, the fucking compass is fucking going haywire.
What's the matter with the compasses today? Are the poles just about to swap? Wish us luck. Wish us luck in the comments.
Another mist cleared briefly and we've been able to see this track down the bottom. It veers off there and there's a little hairpin in the river down there, and we've just been able to see, because that's where we're going, there's the hairpin in the river, there's the track, so we're going to cross the river there at the ford and then head straight up to the settlement. So from that ford we'll know exactly where we are, and then we can take a bearing and just walk up the hill in that general direction. We can't go wrong. This isn't the easiest walk.
No.
Sometimes the straight line navigation, as we keep doing, just keeps leading us through some shit places to walk, doesn't it?
Yeah.
We will learn.
We'll have to. Well, the clouds sort of dropping and falling. You can see a bit more here. It's still misty. Obviously, that's where we've come from. That wasn't very nice terrain to walk down. That's where we're going. Start to see some more defined features. And now this that we're about to walk over looks a bit overgrown with ferns. But we seem to have found a little track for it. No. Why?
Well, I'm not entirely sure. I want to have wet feet for the rest of the...
Yeah, mine are waterproof. The tongue is connected to the...
Yeah, mine's not so much.
Moby ain't bothered. You might have to just take your shoes off, Nath.
Oh, I can't be fucked with that.
I'm going to go. You're going to get wet. That wasn't too bad, was it?
Yeah, soaked.
Oh yeah? Oh mate. You're going to fucking moan about that all the way around now, aren't you? You didn't have to follow me.
That just can't be right. Get your compass. Oh, that's it, your compass is underneath, isn't it? Hold that. Yeah, I think your compass being directly under mine wasn't helping. Now it's telling us we want to go up there, which is where I thought we needed to go. So from the edge of this hairpin in the river, going straight up there.
This is a slog. 200 vertical meters. Mist is still in. In for the day, I don't know, but it's quite interesting, quite nice seeing it sort of ebbing and flowing, revealing things to us around and then shielding us from it all again. It's making for a more interesting day. Keep smiling. We haven't found this summit. You can't see more than 20 meters in front of you, all around you. But we're back on level ground, aren't we, Nath?
Yep.
Where's this summit then? Where's this trip point?
Well, that's exactly why I just come to see you. It's highly possible. It's through there.
What makes you say that?
Well, if we've come up too far to the right, we've hit this plateau area here.
Ah, yeah.
And if you look through there, it seems to start running up again.
And you did have us veering
to the right again to compensate. And if you look, yeah, it seems to go up there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
What do you reckon?
Let's do it.
I think if we go through there, if we don't find the trig point, we get back down to the river, have lunch, take another bearing and try another hill. You happy with that?
Yep.
Cool. Cool. Safest option.
Ta-da.
Ta-da, yeah. Well, after we've had problems with the compasses finding a true north today, so for whatever reason, we don't know. When we come off the river at the bottom, I foolishly didn't 100% trust the bearing that the compass was giving me. Veered right slightly. Fortunately, there is only one hill here. As long as we kept going upwards, we would eventually reach the top. There's no way around that. We've seen a little break in the mist and the hill seemed to run up a little bit to our left. We found a plateau on the map that sort of married up with where we were, so we figured, all right, let's just keep going up. And here we are at the tree point. And the sun's coming out. What are the chances?
Oh look, see that?
How it happens the moment we get up here, we're lost for ages, got nothing to take a bearing off, and then boom.
My wife watched our last video and we touched a pile of stones like that. But she said, you're not meant to do that, you're meant to put the stone at the top. How's your melon?
Bully, rammer.
Oh look, we can see stuff over there now. Get the map out quick. Take bearings.
Trev's a bit paranoid about getting lost in mode.
No, I'm just a bit paranoid about running out of battery before we get finished the adventure.
Before we get lost.
Oh, you never know.
You up, Bert?
Cheeses. We've got crackers, we've got cheeses. See some, you can slice it, you've got knives.
The crackers and cheese seems to be a win every time, doesn't it, really?
Mm. Yeah, we forget the cheese last time, or the crackers. We forgot the crackers, didn't we?
Yeah.
Right. We've orientated the map. We've had a look around us. Can't see anything again now. It's all coming cloudy again. We're just about to set off. We're back in the cloud. But we're facing north over there. We're sat on top of Cosdon Hill, Cosdon Beacon. Behind us due south is Little Hound Tor. Now, I know we came up from this way a bit because we went off track, but it threw me. And when we were orientating the map, I thought we'd come from over that direction. And I looked over there and then I can see these three tors. And I'm like, oh, so what are they? And I look, Belstone Tor, Higher Tor, Belstone Common is where we come from. And I'm thinking, well, we walked up there. So again, I can see how easy it is for someone like me to get lost on this bloody moor. But no, we're going to go now to Little Hound Tor and see what that's all about. It's just about a kilometre and a half away. Now, the rain's coming a bit heavier now, so I've got my Sony out, so the wind might be an issue. I don't want to ruin me SLR, so the next half part of the journey is on this little camera. Well, it's a lot wetter. Still smiling. That's the main thing. At least it keeps you cool. And you can rubber up. There's a rambler heading our way. Should just ramble over to him.
Ramble up to him.
Well, we passed him. Nate's going to tell the story.
I don't know what to say, really. It's the sort of thing that aggravates me. I mean, he's come over the hill and he's just walked up to us. And he's like, oh, which way is Sticklepath? You know, it's an alright question if you're in a car on a road and you've stopped at a garage. But if you're in the middle of the moor on a misty, foggy day, we've got a map and compass and we're struggling to navigate, even though we are getting where we want to go. And he's just wandering around like
an
idiot. In a t-shirt with no waterproof jacket on. And we asked him, well, I said to him, I said, if you just head due north, you're going to come back to Belstone and then it's just right a bit to Sticklepath. And I said, have you got a compass? He's like, no. And it's just like, what the fuck are you doing on top of it, really?
Stone circle. So we're going to go and have a look, investigate the stone circle, aren't we, Nath? We just walked over Little Hound Tor without even realising that we'd walked over it. So we're going to cut across the Big Hound Tor in a minute, which is just Hound Tor, it's not called Big Hound Tor. But we're going to have a look at these stone circles first. I'm going to stand in the middle of them and see if there's any reverberance from the earth that will give me sort of a mystical hindsight of the direction that I need to be driving my life. Because you never know, it happened to David Icke, and look at him now. He's making millions out of idiots. Thank you.
Yeah?
Something about the centre of that, because those sheep was all stood in it. They wouldn't have stood in here for nothing. They must have felt something.
Yeah.
Egging them on. So, next we're going up there. You can't see anything. There's nothing to focus on. Into the wind. Probably. Hound tour.
They're wet. So I've only got the little hot foamy out.
Windy, you can't hear a word. This has been good training today anyway, hasn't it, Nate?
Well, if you can't handle a bit of rain on Dartmoor in July in England, how are you going to handle snow on Mont Blanc?
Precisely! I just wanted to sit down.
Just a quick
sit down. Now we're going to go up there. It doesn't look much of an uplift on the camera, but you know the drill. You people really need to, if you haven't seen Dartmoor before and you're watching this videos, you need to come, because it might look like we're making a big deal out of nothing. Oh, you're walking up a little incline, but actually it's quite, right, it's not mountainous, but it sort of is, it's hilly. It's worse than it looks, right? We're not wimps.
This is the last big ascent of the day, I think.
Yeah.
After this, drop off the other side, pick up that road, and just have a steady walk back to the motor. We could follow the range markers, but we're going to go down, up, river, cross, over. The stage of the day with this weather we've had. I think that's about us, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then, homeward for fires, hot food. I feel like I've been out surviving in the wild for a month.
What's he on about, Moby? Pussy, isn't he? Well, that tested my stamina there. I'm still going. Nath ran up the top. I don't know where he found the energy. I've just had to keep going. Stopping for 10 seconds. Go. It's took long. Seems like fucking ages. It's like fur tour all over again. There's old Fullock.
Very big, I can see him.
That's got me that.
Sometimes, Trev. That's just the whale.
That is the whale. You're right.
Given this is your first day trip hiking on the moors, in the middle of the summer, in horrendous weather, how do you feel about your new favourite pastime?
I still enjoy it. Still come again.
What, on a day like today, when the weather's shit, what is it that keeps you motivated about doing this?
Still getting to see stuff that you wouldn't necessarily see. It's good exercise. I need the exercise. That's my main motivation. And getting my stamina up for when we go climbing up mountains. We're here for a reason, you know. And also it gets me out with my good friend Nath. How's that for an answer?
Yeah, that's good, man. How do you feel, like Snowdon, obviously we've got a small window where we've got a couple of days to go up it.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the prospect of it not being the best weather?
Well, it's something we're just going to have to suck and see, isn't it?
On days like today, motivating, staying happy, staying chirpy, coming up places like this, you know, that's going to prove
hell of a useful if we get faced with a mountain like Nevis, Scarfield Pike, Snowdon, and the weather is great, because we would have travelled a long way to go there, and it would be a shame putting it off just because of a bit of rain and wind, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Oh yeah. We wouldn't like, oh, not doing nothing. Still plenty to see up there, isn't there? The views and, well, this is misty. These valleys, isn't it, Nath? That's what carves these valleys, isn't it, Nath? He's probably getting fed up with me. Keeps stopping and filming. I think he always does. Just wants to get back. We've got 4 kilometres to walk to get back to the car. It's no wonder when we're walking in the opposite direction. He is. He's just thinking of my ankle. I've got a dodgy ankle. He's a good lad, really. I'm only winding him up.
Great way, especially when you're having someone professionally edit what you're doing. It's a great way of remembering these occasions, like, you know. We're outdoors, we're stopping smoking, we're being healthy, we're exercising, and we're not taking the biggest sort of national park in England for granted. You know, we're getting out and we're getting to know it.
Now we're on a track, a proper road. Well, we made it back, we didn't get lost in the mist.
Nope, not once.
I take back everything I said, Nate. You do know what you're doing.
It is debatable. You know, sometimes with a little bit of guesswork involved when you can't see exactly where you're going. It's all part of the fun, innit? Why not?
Well,
happy ding dongs.
Happy ding dang doodles.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's always a pleasure to get back to the vehicle.
Isn't it?
Nice, comfortable seat for the ride. It's still been a good day, innit?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again, Nath.
No worries. Thank you guys as well for joining us.
CD.
Yeah. Leave comments below. Let us know what you think of our adventures. Where we should go next from here. Summit.
Or nothing.
Peace.